These are some of the most beautiful and inspiring structures in the universe. Now, as you know, they aren't solid disks. They're a gigantic spill of individual stars webbed together by gravity. So there are a few rough fundamental shapes that a galaxy can have. And the bulk of these are some variation of a spiral. Each one with twisting arms of stars that reach tens of thousands of light years in every direction along a plane out from a galactic core. So what gives them this characteristic spiral shape? The earliest galaxies didn't have clearly defined spiral arms. They were either two-armed or they had thick, irregular, chaotic, woolly arms with star-forming clumps. So after 3.6 billion years, the chaos had settled down into the shapes that we see today. But it took until the universe was 8 billion years old for these modern, multi-armed spirals like the Milky Way or Andromeda to appear. So where did they come from? These arms are in fact density waves passing through the galaxy, with stars moving in and out of the waves. The arms themselves aren't permanent structures made of the same clumps of stars. So imagine driving down a highway and people are slowing down to gape slack-jawed at a crashed alien saucer. So we're gonna use our crashed alien saucer provided by the Kerbal Space Program, love that game, right there on the highway. And so cars are gonna drive up and they're gonna slow down as they reach the saucer, and then they form a clump to watch out their window. And then the lead car accelerates away and other cars come in to take their place. So the members of the clump always change, but the clump remains along the highway. And it's the same thing with the stars that move through the galaxy. As the density wave approaches, stars accelerate towards it. And then they slow down as they move away from it, just like a comet falling into the gravity well of the sun. And when the density wave moves through an area, it kicks off an era of star formation. So the material of the galaxy is being constantly stirred and new stars are born as a density wave makes its way through the galaxy. So when you picture this, keep in mind that stars closer to the core of the galaxy orbit faster than the spiral arm, and the stars further out go more slowly. Our galaxy, the Milky Way, takes about 240 million years to complete a full rotation. But we pass through a major spiral arm every 100 million years or so, remaining in the higher density region for about 10 million years. Astronomers have only recently figured out why these arms exist in the first place. Originally, they suspected it might be like a garden sprinkler with material fountaining out from the center of the galaxy or channeled by magnetic fields. They also thought that these arms might be transient features appearing and disappearing over time. But new evidence and simulations show they're long-lasting. They believe the arms themselves form as the result of giant molecular clouds of hydrogen. These clouds initiate the arms and keep the shape sustained over billions of years. So what do you think? What's your favorite spiral galaxy? Tell us in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Never miss an episode by clicking subscribe. The Guide to Space is made possible by the members of our Patreon community. And we'd like to thank Ryan Pearson and the many others who contribute to help us bring great space and astronomy content every month. If you'd like to join our community and get advanced access to episodes as well as extra and behind the scenes content, click here and check out our page on Patreon.